Are expensive coaxial cables worth the money, or are the cheapest cables on Amazon and AliExpress just as good? Let's find out with the Rohde & Schwarz ZMBA Vector Network Analyzer. As our reference for an expensive coaxial cable, we have a Rosenberger LU7 metrology grade microwave cable assembly that costs around $600. Then we have a range of cheap cables, some costing as little as a dollar each. Let's start by looking at the impedance along the cable. With the ZNB displaying distance to fault and the trace measuring impedance in ohms, the Rosenberger cable is bang on 50 ohms along its length. The spike is the unterminated end of the cable. Adding a 50 ohm terminator to the cable cleans up the impedance plot from the reflections off the unterminated end. We're left with a small discontinuity where the adapter and terminator are. This discontinuity allows us to measure the cable as perfectly 1 meter long at the midpoint of the adapter. Our first budget cable is from Amazon, labeled as a Vekis SMA to BNC RG316 cable. With the cable end terminated, well, it's not as uniform as the Rosenberger cable. Be interesting to see what this does to losses. The connector doesn't appear to be very high quality. Measuring from the SMA connector end, there's a significant discontinuity at the connectors. The cable has a different velocity factor from the RG316 specifications. I measured the cable as 1 meter with a tape measure, but the VNA measures the electrical length as 985 millimeters. I also have sourcing map cables that are similar in price, but a little longer. Their impedance is similar to the previous cables, but the connectors look a little better on the VNA as the impedance discontinuity is a little less dramatic at the connectors. The VNA measures the cable at 1.18 meters, but I measured the length with a tape measure as 1.2 meters long, so the velocity factor matches the RG316 specification much better. A little more mid-range in price are SMA to BNC cables from Amphenol, which I source from DigiKey. These are my typical day-to-day use cables for connecting devices to my oscilloscope. The coax has much more consistent impedance than the cheap cables, more in line with the Rosenberger. However, the connectors are not much better than sourcing map cables from Amazon. This cable will be very interesting to compare to the cheap cables to see how much impact the more uniform impedance of the cable has compared to the connectors. We have some short SMA to BNC cables from AliExpress for the last cables today. The coaxial cable impedance is better than expected, similar to the Amphenol, but the connectors leave much to be desired. They're the worst we've seen. Now let's look at the most interesting aspects of the cable, insertion loss. This is an S21 or S12 measurement, how much signal loss we have between ports 1 and ports 2, or between ports 2 and ports 1. The loss shown for the Rosenberger cable is substantially greater than the test report for the cables. However, I can easily put this down to the fact the cable is much better quality than the calibration standards we used. I've only performed an open short match calibration on the ZNB. I don't have a higher quality through than the Rosenberger cable, so I expect the measurement quality to be lower than Rosenberger's test report. Performing a target search for the -3 dB point, it shows as around 8 GHz. For most cables I'd use day to day, I consider this pretty decent, but Rosenberger's test report shows an insertion loss of only about -1.1 dB at 18 GHz. Let's save the current trace to memory to compare the other cables directly to the Rosenberger. Returning to the Vekis cable with an S21 measurement, we measure the signal received by port 2 that has been transmitted from port 1. In this case, the signal is measured from the SMA connector to the BNC connector. The first -3 dB crossing is at just under 1.6 GHz, measuring from the BNC connector to the SMA connector. The -3 dB point is basically the same. The cable is fine if you want to connect a board to a 50 MHz or 100 MHz scope, but it's not something you'd want to use for anything much higher frequency or RF related. Moving on to the sourcing map cables. They are better than the Vecchis, but still have quite a lot of attenuation relative to the Rosenberger. The Vecchis cable was pretty much identical with the signal propagating in both directions. However, the sourcing map cable is a little better in one direction than the other. The non-uniformity of the coaxial cable is probably the cause here, with more reflection and attenuation from one direction than the other due to the variations in impedance. The short AliExpress cable looks a lot better. The coaxial cable on this one was far more uniform than the Amazon sourced cables. This bears out with the S21 measurement and a minus 3 dB point of almost 3.8 GHz, given the connector or connector termination impedance being the worst of the bunch. It's pretty clear that the more uniform cable has much more impact on loss than the connectors. So what about the Amphenol cables I've been using for a lot of my measurements? Should I have been trusting the measurements? It looks like it's not too bad. It's definitely not in the same league as the Rosenberger, but for my measurements, which have mostly been sub 2 GHz, I feel as though they're worth the money. Now, if we consider the loss on the Rosenberger cable compared to Amphenol at the higher frequencies, and consider the Rosenberg test report, then the minus 3 dB point should be better than the 6 GHz bandwidth of my fastest scope. So what have we found? We can get an Amphenol RF cable that performs a lot better for two or three times the price of cheap cables from Amazon or AliExpress. We can get a near perfect metrology grade cable with some very high quality connectors for 100 times the price of a cheap cable. For day-to-day testing or amateur radio applications, I feel it's not really worth buying the low-cost cables. The jump in price to a name brand cable from a supplier like DigiKey, Mouser or Farnell comes with a substantial uplift in performance. The Rosenberger cables are pretty amazing, but given the cost, I feel they should be reserved for calibration or critical measurements, rather than just general testing, at least with the sort of products I work on. I hope you found that useful and have a fantastic week.